It looks like now the remains of dozens of people seized in the BioCare case may never be returned to their families. Medical investigators have finished DNA testing on more than 45 sets of remains and say they may simply never know who some of the dead people are. Here's News 13's Alex Tomlin.
Dick, the bodies are sitting in a trailer outside of the OMI office because the office has nowhere to put them.
That is a lot of bodies, particularly in parts, to receive. We had no room in our coolers.
For 4 months, the remains of at least 45 people have been in this refrigerated trailer just outside the medical investigator's office on UNM's North Campus.
We're hoping to get that cleared out by sometime next week.
For weeks, doctors have worked every possible angle to try and identify all the bodies.
We have photographed everyone. We've x-rayed them all. We've x-rayed any clothing. We've looked up any serial numbers of any implants that were found. We have collected DNA samples on every single one of the specimens.
OMI took control of the bodies after 7 heads and dozens of body parts were sent to a medical waste incinerator in Kansas City. They were traced back to BioCare, a medical donation company in Albuquerque. The cremated remains of 3 of the bodies found in Kansas City had supposedly already been returned to the families. So BioCare owner Paul Montano was charged with fraud. The next day, OMI and police took control of more remains from inside his Albuquerque business. Now that DNA results are back, OMI officials will start matching parts. Then the remains will be cremated and labeled by their DNA strands in case families come forward to claim any of the bodies.
Would have to go to a DNA laboratory that could do comparison DNA that's something like paternity testing.
OMI also has some body parts that weren't properly refrigerated at BioCare.
There may be parts that never would be identified.
Only 18 of the bodies have been ID'd so far. OMI hopes APD will store all of the unidentified cremated remains. Dick?
All right, Alex. The criminal charges against Montano were actually dropped earlier this month, but that is only while investigators work to make the case stronger. The charges will then be refiled. Montano also faces civil suits from family members who received the wrong ashes.